If you want to know how to clear your mind of negative thoughts, you have to understand your mind. Welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Sylvia Sello and I'm a spiritual coach, author and public speaker. And I help people to embody their souls, the highest aspects of themselves. Has it ever happened to you that you wake up and you have the same thoughts over and over again? Maybe you are doubting yourself, maybe you are feeling jealous, maybe you are feeling like you cannot go after your dreams. There are those negative thoughts in your head and they are like playing on a loop and you don't know how to switch it off. Or maybe you are going through relationships that seem to be going exactly the same way. So at the end of that relationship, you feel the same way as you had felt before. And you seem to make the same mistakes as you did before. Or perhaps you don't enjoy your work and you don't feel recognized and appreciated and seen. And you are thinking, this is not what I was born to do. I don't really enjoy my job, but you are afraid to go after your dreams. And even if you change your job still, you feel and think the same way. To understand how to break the negative cycle, this negative vicious cycle of your thoughts, you have to understand your mind. So for this simplicity, I will divide the mind into three different parts. The first is the subconscious mind, which is the most important for us. The subconscious mind is something like a huge storage. It's like a data bank. Everything that you have ever heard, experienced, everything that you have ever seen gets saved into this storage. So all that information goes into folders. So one folder, let's say, is everything related to how to ride a bicycle. Another folder can be related to being envy or jealous or controlling, manipulative. So there is like everything that you've ever heard or seen, experienced, is going right into this folder. So your subconscious mind is basically helping you to grow and learn. And why it's called the subconscious mind is because you are not conscious of what is exactly in those folders. If you were fully conscious of it, you would become crazy because there is a huge data. There is so much information that you don't have to, you know, have the conscious access to it all the time. So your subconscious mind basically takes it from the conscious mind once you don't need that information, when it's like old and expired, and it puts it into those folders. The other part of the mind is the conscious mind, which is what you are now hopefully having activated when you are watching this video. You are paying attention to what I am saying. You are seeing me. You are conscious of what is happening. You are not like living on autopilot. You use your conscious mind. For example, if you are walking outside and it's very busy street and you have to pay attention if, I don't know, there is a car coming or, you know, someone's riding fast on a bicycle or you are hearing some strange noises. So your conscious mind is basically keeping you alert and helping you to pay attention to what is happening in your environment. The other part of your mind is the unconscious mind, which is directly linked to the collective unconscious. And this doesn't have to bother you just yet. It's related like, okay, if you are dealing with some addictions and so on, some like very, let's say, deep demons, then you would want to look into the unconscious mind. But for the purpose of this video, we will be just focusing on the subconscious mind. As I said, the subconscious mind is like this huge storage of information. So when you are born, you take in any information from your parents. So anything that they tell you, anything that they, you know, show you, teach you, anything that you experience goes directly into your subconscious mind. This is how you learn. And if you are little, you basically don't have developed the conscious mind. The conscious mind can say, oh, maybe it doesn't make sense to learn it this way, or it doesn't make sense what you are telling me. So the conscious mind kind of like puts in that present consciousness and that present realization that maybe what's going on is not true, or maybe it's not for your highest purpose. But until we are 3 years old, we take in any information for granted. We don't question anything. So if your parents tell you like, you are the most loving, the sweetest child in the world, you take it as a fact. If your parents tell you, oh, you're an annoying child, you're so loud and so noisy, and you know, you should just go into your room and not bother us, you take it for granted. You will think, oh, I'm so annoying people with my presence. And your subconscious mind also starts to link those pieces of information and create stories around them and look for more evidence to support those informations. And this is where it gets really tricky for us, because the moment when we get older, we basically mostly operate from our subconscious mind only. So when some situation happens in your life, your subconscious mind starts to go back into your past to some experience that seems to be similar to what you are going through now. And it tells you, oh, I know how to deal with this situation because, I don't know, 20 years ago, something similar happened and this is how it was dealt with. And to make it even more interesting, it's not only about what other people tell you. So it's not only what your, let's say, siblings, parents, your teachers, your friends tell you about yourself or generally what they say out loud, but it's also about how they feel. It's also about their energy states. So for example, if your parents would be having problems in their relationships and they would be arguing behind the doors, but they would never really say it out loud, you would still pick up on that information. You would feel it. You would feel that something is off, something is wrong. And I think this is even more dangerous in a way, because then that information, that energy flows into you and you start questioning yourself at some point. You start to question your intuition. You start to question your natural gifts of being an empath and of like recognizing and reading these situations, because there is that disconnection. You feel something, you are aware of something, but on the surface, it's like, it doesn't look like that this is the case. So you start to truly doubt yourself and your own inner guidance. But as I said, like you are taking in any information, even emotions and energies of people, their mental states, their spiritual evolution, like everything. You are constantly picking up those information from your environment. And of course, some people are more open to it, some people less, but we all do it at some level. And basically, until you are like 8 years old, you are like mostly done. I mean, you mostly have those patterns, those designs for your life, how you should approach to each situation. And then, of course, when you have your first like serious friendships, when you have your first loves, when you have your first job, you go to college and so on, then you get more information. And then when we are adult and, you know, let's say that you graduated from school and you are in your work, you had some relationships already, then you are mostly done. You are living on autopilot without even realizing it. So you basically follow the blueprint of your subconscious mind. It tells you what you should do, what choices you should make, and you are following them. And it feels like it feels like you are doing all the right steps in your life, when in fact, you are not conscious of what you are doing. You are not present. Let me give you an example. Let's say that your mom didn't follow her dreams. Let's say that she wanted to achieve something. She had this strive and dreams, but for whatever reason, she didn't go after her dreams. And she became very bitter and she became disappointed with life and she became sad and even depressed. And when you were growing up, you could feel all those emotions, it was going into you. And you started to develop this kind of stories and thinking that says perhaps that it's not good to go after your dreams because it can make you feel depressed and sad, or you cannot achieve your dreams because your mom didn't, so how could you, right? And all those stories starts to develop in your subconscious mind. And then in your current life, you experience some triggering moment. So let's say that you are thinking about having own business, or you are thinking about changing your job. There is some dreams that you have, and before you fall asleep, you like to imagining it, and you are thinking maybe one day. And then when it starts to be like more concrete, a dream, when you start to feel it even more, and you are thinking perhaps like I could do something about it. In that moment, your subconscious mind will go to the closest information it has about your current situation. So in this case, it would go back to your past, to your mom, because those imprints that we receive from our parents or caregivers are impacting us the most. They are the strongest role models for our behavior, for our choices. So it goes back to your mom and it starts to tell you that actually it's not okay to go after your dreams. And you should feel sad, you should feel depressed, you should give up as well because she did. And you suddenly start to feel her emotions that she was going through. And you start to feel like and think her beliefs and thoughts. And suddenly you start to talk your way away from your dream. Also, what you will do is that you don't want to deal with that frustration that you don't know how to go after your dreams. So you will take it out somewhere. So you will, for example, if you are in a relationship, you will create problems in your relationship. So you don't have to look inside and deal with what you are feeling. So you can create any kind of problem on the outside. It doesn't matter, whatever it is. So you don't have to feel the deep pain that you have inside of you. You will sabotage yourself at all levels, just so that you don't look within yourself. This is like what most people are doing. We all have the subconscious mind, obviously. We all are going through those same stages. But what is different from people, for example, who go after their dreams from those who don't, is that those who go after their dreams, they start to look at their subconscious mind and they are like, wait a minute, is it true that I cannot make my dream happen? Do those beliefs and those emotions belong to me? And you start to look at your subconscious mind, you start to look at that programming that you have there, and you start to bring it to your consciousness. So you will be able to look at it as it is, not as the illusion or as the past pain. You will not be experiencing your past over and over again. You break that cycle. So to clear your mind of negative thoughts, you have to basically trace back those beliefs, the thoughts that you have to your past. Very often it goes back to parents or even earlier than that, but that would be a different story. But you trace it back to your childhood and then you have to change that belief system. You have to, first of all, recognize that you are not those beliefs, those thoughts. And your mom, you know, she was feeling this way very likely because of her mom and because of her mom and her mom. This is how we pass information and how we pass limitations and also, of course, potentialities, because it can be also a positive, this programming. But we pass everything from generation to generation. So we are already like, you know, we are book full of letters. We are not like tabula rasa, which is like blank, you know, canvas that you can just create anything there. No, we are pretty much imprinted, designed, conditioned, programmed already. And so you realize you are not this programming. Yes, you have it. You are aware of it, but you are not it. Then you will have to do some, you know, shadow work around this topic. You will have to do something to release the emotional charge, because there's a lot of emotional pain related to it. And also there is stuck energy. So you will have to start releasing those emotions and releasing the energy. And then the last step is to bring in the higher consciousness. So if you connect to your higher self will show you the lessons and teachings of that situation. Because even though it looks like something negative, it looks like, oh, I cannot go after my dreams because my mom didn't and now I'm suffering. So don't be a victim. It's not like that. There is always something very positive related to it. You just have to search for it. What is the lesson? What is it teaching you? And then you go and integrate those lessons and teachings in your life. And then that cycle is over. Now, of course, this is a process, like to work with the subconscious mind, it takes years. So you will have to do it with many of your beliefs. So it's really about the commitment and the work, but you don't have to do everything all at once. You do it as those beliefs are coming to you. So they usually like anytime you clear out something and then you are going to the next level. And on that moment when you are leaving one comfort zone and going into another, this is where the subconscious mind gets really loud. And if you are interested, you can watch my another video about this topic, which is how these fears of our potential are controlling us subconsciously. And also, if you want more resources, I will link them down below. You can subscribe to my newsletter and you can download free ebook, How to Master Your Mind. You can also read my book, How to Become the CEO of Your Mind, which will give you a lot of tools how you can start reprogramming your mind. And also, I will be posting new videos on this topic in the upcoming weeks. So please stay tuned, because I will give you more tools how to deal with the subconscious mind. And now I have a question for you. Have you ever noticed that you are going through the same emotions in your life? So let's say you are going through the same patterns in your relationships, or you are close about to making a breakthrough in your life and then you sabotage yourself. So have you noticed this? And the reason I want you to write it down is because in that moment you are bringing it to the conscious awareness. And it's not like controlling you so much anymore. It's so important to recognize and take ownership for what is happening in your mind. So thank you so much for watching and see you next time.